Hi, I'm back. So, I wound up having quite a bit happen in the last week and a half since my last video, and I was fitted for my mold. I may have already told you that, for radiation, but I had my five radiation treatments that they aimed at the biggest problem spot in my spine. And I also had a port put in so that they could give me my chemo through a port, which makes it a lot easier than trying to start a brand new IV every time you go in. Especially, I'm what they call a hard stick, so it sometimes can take a few tries before they get things going. So that was nice to have the port put in, and it was a relatively simple procedure. You're kind of under the twilight sleep, like when you have a colonoscopy or something like that, and you're not awake, but you're not super deep sleep that like general anesthesia would completely knock you out. I didn't remember anything. It was quick, it was easy, and everything went smooth, so that was great. Yeah. So I apologize in advance if this shakes a little, but my puppy dog decided to jump up here because she wanted to be next to me and, involved in this video somehow. But so I had my first chemo treatment on Monday the 22nd, and that morning prior to that, I had my last radiation treatment. And so I had those five radiation treatments, and I really could tell by the fifth treatment, a couple days after it, that I believe it helped already because my back pain had alleviated so much. So when I went in with the visit for like ending the, finishing up the five treatments and going over with the doctor if I had any questions or anything, I asked him, I said, "Where exactly did you aim the radiation exactly?" Because he had the computer there so he could show me. So he pulled it up on a screen and it looked like kind of like blueprints. And I could see right where everything was aimed, and it was aimed at that thoracic vertebrae that was so lit up with cancer. And they did a good job, I think, aiming, because I have had some major relief from just the five treatments of radiation in my back. I didn't get any of the sunburning because, I'm not sure if it's because it wasn't super strong radiation or if it was just because there were five treatments only. There I go. The five treatments seemed to help. So I still have kind of like a bank of five treatments that I can have if I have a problem that comes up again somewhere. He was explaining that they want to save it for like those kind of places in your body that are weight-bearing, crucial. Like you don't want your spine to break. And he said if I were to get something like, say, in my femur, that's a main weight-bearing bone, so they would use that other five on something like that. So I kind of have a bank of the five radiation treatments still left. And the reason they're only doing 10 is because I had so much radiation 34 years ago, and I guess that you're supposed to have like so much, and I've had a lot. And so I guess after I use the next five, if I have to, not really sure what we'll do if like another situation comes up, but we'll visit that when and if it happens. So had that last radiation treatment Monday morning, and then Monday afternoon, before lunch, I went up to start with my first chemotherapy, and I wound up being there about 5.5 hours because they started the IV in my port, and my port's right here. You can see it's still healing, but it's not too bad. So that's that ugly spot, that's glue. They just used glue to hold it together, and all the stitching is underneath the skin. So the glue is kind of a light blue in color, and they said don't pick it off, just let it wear off. So, and then there's a little tiny incision right there that most of the glue has worn off already, and they use that to kind of pull the port. Looks like a little triangle thing, and it has a long rubber tube that hangs from it. So they put the port in, and then they take the tube and they put it into an artery, I believe. I don't know if it's a carotid artery or what it is. And then it goes back down that artery. And hang on just one sec. I had a phone call coming in. Comes back down that artery, and I don't know if it goes all the way to your heart or just way down the artery. I don't know exactly. But all I know is I don't have to get an IV stick every time I go. All I got to do is put a good slather of numbing lotion on there, like about an hour beforehand. And really cool little tip the nurse told me is to get some press and seal, and then you can cut it and put it over the gel, and then that like keeps your clothes clean. And rather than using like a gauze and tape, I used a gauze and tape the first time because that's what the instruction said, was cover it with a piece of gauze and some tape. And she said the gel kind of soaks into the gauze, but if you use press and seal, it doesn't soak into the gauze. It just stays there and soaks into your skin. And so fortunately I had enough gooped on there that it worked great. And when she was getting ready to start the IV into my port, she just said, okay, I want you to take a deep breath in. Another phone call, hang on. Popular time for phone calls. I want you to take a deep breath in, and she was gonna do it. So I took a deep breath. I barely felt anything, just maybe a little bit of pressure. And I was so happy because I didn't know what to expect. I'd only had the port, I got it put in on Thursday, and this was Monday. So it was still a little bit sore just because, you know, they had made an incision. And so I was real concerned that it was just going to hurt because it was kind of a fresh thing and it wasn't completely healed. But the doctor that put the port in when I left, it was great. The kind of sedation they use, it's the kind where you're just, I mean, you still have to have a driver, but it's the kind where you feel wide awake afterward. You don't feel groggy and hungover and all that. And he said that, okay, you know, it's in, it went great. And basically I could have walked out of there, walked into chemo, and they could have accessed it right away, you know. And that's kind of shocking. I'm glad I didn't have to do it immediately that fast. But I was still kind of impressed that they could do that. So, but I was still a little nervous, you know, on Monday. And I didn't need to be. It was fine. So they give you a lot of pre-meds. I had like Benadryl, Tylenol. I think they gave me a steroid for anti-inflammatory. And I'm wanting to say there was a fourth one. I can't remember what the fourth one was. maybe there wasn't a fourth one, but I think there was a fourth one. I just can't remember what it was. So they kind of pre-medicate you, because when I was getting also an iron infusion at the same, you know, also at the same time, and they always would give me a pre-med for iron infusion because sometimes those can cause anaphylactic shock or whatever. And then they gave me a little bit more of a cocktail of pre-meds because I was having the chemotherapy too. And so we did the pre-meds, and then before they do the pre-meds, I think they flush with some saline, then the pre-meds, and then they like flush with some saline, and then they did the iron, and then they flush with some saline, and then they did one of the drugs for the chemo treatment and flushed with saline, and then they did the other one. And the one that had the potential for the worst side effects, they did that one last. And they made it go a lot slower than they normally would. It was like a 90 minute just for that one drug, because that way, if you have any kind of reaction to it, they can jump on it, and it's not going in as heavy as once they know you, that it seems like you're going to be able to tolerate it okay. So I was there for about 5.5 hours. I seemed to tolerate everything okay, and then I left. And so that was Monday. And so back in the 90s, usually the next 2 days after, I would kind of pretty much be out of it, because I would be throwing up all the time taking the anti-nausea that I had then. And a lot of the stuff I took back then made me sleep. And because I was sleeping, then I didn't throw up. And so I would be kind of out of it for a couple of days, and then come around on about the third day after. And so I was anticipating, you know, Tuesday feeling pretty crummy, because it would have been the day after my chemo. But surprisingly, the only real side effect that I noticed was complete insomnia. I was wide awake, not tired at all, just wide awake all night long, until I heard my husband's alarm go off for him to get up to go to work. And so I thought, well, after he goes to work, then I will see if I can fall asleep. Nope. Got up, still wide awake. And so I thought, oh, well, I'll take advantage of this. I'm feeling good. I'm not feeling nauseated. So I did things around the house and kind of just kept waiting for some nausea to hit or something, and it didn't. I was so excited. And so I thought, well, that, you know, I'll take that. And so then this morning I messaged my doctor, and I said that I had a really hard night with no sleeping, and I can't take melatonin because it gives me nightmares. And so I asked her if she suggested anything, and she gave me a suggestion, but it was after I'd already gone to go get something else over the counter. And so I wound up just getting the Z NyQuil, and because it doesn't have melatonin in it. And I did that, and I slept. So I found something that helped me fall asleep, so that was good. And I think I only got up once, and so that was great. So I got sleep last night, and again today I didn't have any nausea. Thank you, Lord. He like probably has answered a lot of prayers, because my husband and my kids remember how I spent half my time in the 90s vomiting, and it was just not fun. So I'm ecstatic. And I mean, I have anti-nausea that the doctor gave me, Zofran, if I need it. And so far, so good. I haven't needed it. I had energy to go run a lot of errands today. Yeah, it was great. So I'm pretty happy with way things are going so far. And one of the things that I did today was I got a little, let me see here. Well, that's not fun to see me so close. I got a journal and it's all bloom, no gloom. And what I thought I'd do is kind of journal the my experiences that I'm having with all this new little cancer journey that I'm going on. And also what I want to do is I am getting, you know, a lot of ideas and tips and suggestions and things for alternative treatments. So like if my traditional route doesn't work and I'm going to ever venture out to try something that's not so traditional, then what I'm doing is I am going to log in the journal the different ideas and non-traditional medicines and things like that and do research on them and just kind of have some notes beside each one. And because I've had a few things suggested to me, and when I looked up some of them, some have never had studies done on them, but some have. And I found that some of the ideas that I've been given to possibly help me get through this specifically have had studies that say you don't want to do this if you have breast cancer because it promotes breast cancer. It's more for pancreatic cancer, I guess. And so I want to have kind of a log of that so that when I do, if I do need to go to something alternative, that it'll be a little easier to at least know which ones that may be an alternative and which ones I probably want to steer away from, depending on the information that I've found out. And so, yeah, and then I'm just going to kind of journal and, you know, thoughts and feelings and probably throw in some extra stuff because I tend to jump around. And there I go again. Yeah. But this is kind of where I'm at now. I will try to do a video when I'm at this cancer center having my treatment so that you can see what I have picked up to help get through the chemo treatments. I've got a few things that I wound up getting that are kind of interesting and fun, and who knows if it'll work or not, but I'm gonna try. And so they have little private rooms, and then they have curtained off rooms. And I was in one of the curtained off rooms, and it's not quite as private, so I don't know how easy it will be to do a little video, but I'll try. And to show you my little get up and what I'm experimenting with. So talk to you next time. Bye.